In the realm of space travel, astronauts and mission control teams represent the epitome of precise packers. Due to the incredibly expensive cost of transporting items to space, even the smallest objects, these items must be meticulously inventoried and recorded. One of the most essential and weighty items in space is water. Given that, one might wonder how astronauts maintain a supply of potable water while onboard spacecraft for months at a time. Humanity's furthest established outpost in space is the International Space Station, or the ISS. Acting as a steady abode to a handful of astronauts at any given time, this orbiting lab represents a critical point of departure for research and operational efforts. As mentioned, sending items into space is a costly endeavor. To illustrate, the launch of a SpaceX rocket alone costs over $2,500 per pound. Thus, regularly shipping water to and from Earth is financially infeasible. To overcome the water woes aboard the ISS, there are several innovative measures in place. Admittedly, these techniques may be discomforting for the squeamish. While onboard the ISS, dealing with a limited water supply and virtually no way to restock, astronauts must resort to recycling. When aboard the ISS, water is lost each time an astronaut exhales or perspires. Though minute, when these vapors are collected from a crew of six, plus occasional visitors, they can potentiate the ambient cabin humidity. Ultimately, these vapors are condensed and utilized to top up the general water reserves of the ISS. Furthermore, the ISS houses a specialized water management system that extracts every possible drop of accessible water. From the breath of astronauts, shower water runoff, hand wash and oral hygiene residue, to sweat and even urine. As quoted by Layne Carter, the manager of the ISS water system, "The water tastes like bottled water, so long as one can psychologically override the fact that it's recycled sweat and pee." Even the onboard animals contribute to this sustainable initiative. They also breathe out and urinate, which in turn contributes to the effort for water conservation. Without such stringent measures, it would necessitate 40,000 pounds of Earth-derived water to sustain only four crew members for a year aboard the ISS. Notably, the recycled water on board is actually purer than our regular tap water here on Earth. However, for water to be recycled, some water is required in the first place. For this reason, the Russian module Zarya on the ISS holds contingency water containers, or CWCs. Each CWC is similar to a duffel bag and can hold around 90 pounds of water. Interestingly, not all astronauts aboard the ISS drink urine-recycled water. The Russian segment of the ISS employs a separate water filtration system that only uses water from shower runoff and condensate. Despite the effectiveness of these water conservation systems, they are not wholly efficient. Researchers are continually striving for the development of ever more efficient machinery and support systems to minimize water wastage while maximizing water recovery from waste products. The importance of water conservation aboard the ISS is paramount, making its inhabitants perhaps some of the most water-conscious individuals on the planet, or above it.